Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see the Lineage OS version 17.1, which is based on Android version 10, and here it is an official one. So guys, let's begin. So as you guys can see here, this is the Lineage OS, and the Android version here is the Android 10. And the security patch level you get here is the latest one, the 5th of February 2021. So yes, which is a great thing that you are getting the latest security patch. And I don't know what kernel here it is. This is the, what you say, smiley kernel or what, and what language it is written. I just don't know what kernel here it is. If you know, then please let me know in the comment section. But so far the kernel is just great and it's performing great in the room. So watch the video till the end, and going to the settings. This is the settings, just the normal settings, Android 10. I'll just not show you each and everything, but the customizations here are limited only. You get to see the buttons customization. These are the just the buttons customization, just the same. The end call, the long press for torch, home button customization, the recent button, double tap and long press. That is it for the buttons. You have the volume buttons, the wake device with volume button, answer call and everything. So these are all the buttons customizations available. Then moving forward, you get to see the status bar here. The option for network traffic monitor here is available, and you can turn it on from here. And you get to see the system icons and everything, the battery indicator style and the brightness and everything. So yes, this is it. And in the gestures, these are the only options you get: jump to camera and prevent ringing. So yeah, these are the only things in the customizations available. Otherwise, this is just the pure, the stock Android 10 ROM, and you get to see the Xiaomi parts available here, which is just the same and everything you get. Then going back to the settings, here is the settings and security. In security, everything is working. The fingerprint sensor here is working, but in my phone, the hardware is just broken. So it is not working for me, and you don't get to see the face unlock option also. So yeah, these are the options in the security. And the screen lock here is just working absolutely fine. There is no lock screen bug or anything. So yes, that is great. Then moving to the sounds and vibrations, these are just the same options available here. The vibrate for calls and everything. No new options. There are no vibration patterns available. So yes, then going to the display options, these are all the display options, the live display you get, and you get to see the styles and wallpapers, display size and everything. Double tap to wake up unplug and prevent accidental wake up. So these are the options in the display. Then going forward to the battery here, this is the battery options. And talking about the battery life, I must say the battery life here is great. From using this from 2 days, and I am easily getting around 4 to 5 hours of screen on time, so which is in my terms a great battery life. I will show you the device full usage. I had charged it at 91%, and from 91 to 75% I got 1 hour and 2 minutes of screen on time. So yes, this is in my opinion a great battery backup for a 5-year-old phone. So yes, that is it. These were these settings. Now going to the home screen, this is just the normal home screen. This is not the Pixel launcher here, this is the Lineage OS launcher. Now on tapping home screen, these are the home settings available here, and you get to see the icon pack and hide apps. So you can hide the apps in this room. So yes, this is a great launcher that you can hide the apps, and you can just access from here only. Talking about the quick settings, as you can see here, these gestures are not working. You have to stretch your hands up till the status bar to get to the quick settings here. These are the quick settings. The Wi-Fi here is working. Mobile data here is also working absolutely fine. As you can see, the mobile data LTE sign here is showing, and you get to see the torch and everything here is just working. The screen recorder option on these quick settings here is just not available. You have to enable it from the developer option. So on press and hold the normal option, you get to see the screenshot option. Now if you want to get the screen recorder, just go to the settings. First of all, just enable the developer option. go to the developer option, and in the developer option you get to see the option feature flags. As you can see, this is the option feature flags. Just go to it and on the settings underscore screen record long press option, just turn it on. Now press and hold the power button and press and hold on the screenshot option. So now you will get to see the screen record option available here. So yes, this is how you can get the screen recorder. And otherwise, talking about the camera here, the stock camera you get is the Snapdragon Cam, which as you know I just don't use if you follow me from my previous video. So guys, if you still haven't subscribed to the channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel, and there will be the name of the Telegram group here. You can join the Telegram group, and also the link will be in the description below, so you can join it from there. So join the Telegram group if you still haven't joined it. Then this is the Google camera I am using. This is the Gcam 4.1, which is working absolutely fine, and the other Gcams. So this is the Gcam I have installed, and now let's start it up. So as you can see, this is the Gcam 7.0, which is working absolutely fine. As you can see, you get to see the night sight, the lens blur option. This is the Google camera version 7.0. Going to the settings, I'll just show you which version it is. This APK is for the Poco F1, but I don't know, the phone just got hanged as you can see. So yeah, this is an issue with the Gcam, not with the ROM. So yes, the Google camera version 7.3 is just not working. Now I have to reboot it. So guys, by the time I reboot the phone, you can just hit to the subscribe button, you know, it would be great. Okay, now talking about the Geekbench scores here, so these are the Geekbench score 293 and 624. According to the score, the performance just don't seem much better, like, but the scores just don't matter here, because the performance is I think better than Nusantra ROM, because this is more stable than Nusantra. And also, the talking about the overall performance, the RAM management here is better than any other ROM. The performance, overall performance here is just great, and I must say this is better than Nusantra ROM. It's fluid and I haven't faced any lags or stutters so far, but yes, so far so good. The ROM is performing just great and performance is also great. I'll just show you the RAM management here. I'm opening these 2-3 apps in front of you, and we will see that which apps are remain in the memory till the end. So these are the apps I had opened, and as you can see, the Geekbench app here is still in the RAM. Then going to the settings app here is also in the RAM, the photos app here is also in the RAM. So yes, the RAM management is just great on this ROM. Yeah, I have to mention it, because so far I haven't seen this good RAM management in any ROM. So yeah, just appreciating it. Then moving forward to the safety net here, the safety net status has also passed. So the banking apps will run absolutely fine, and also the Play Store has certified. The device certification is just certified. I'll just show it to you. As you can see, Play Protect certification, device is certified. So no worries with that too. Then moving forward to the speed test here, the internet speed test here is just also not an issue. I'll just directly show you the results. Here are the results, 54.9 and 23.5. This is the Wi-Fi internet speed test, and you will get similar results in the VISIM LTE, VoLTE, whatever you say it. So yes, this was it. Then talking about the bugs, honestly speaking, I haven't faced any bugs yet. As you can see, this is one of the thing, like it just takes a second to show the display when I double tap, and after a minor delay it just turns on the display. So yes, this was it. This was the only problem I have faced, and sometimes I am facing that whenever I am receiving the call, the ringtone just rings and after a second it shows me the name. So yes, this was the issue, and these were the bugs I am facing. Yeah, and otherwise I must appreciate the ROM, the performance, the RAM management, everything is just great. So yeah, that is it for now. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, then you can ask me in the comment section below or in the Telegram group. I'll meet you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, have fun, and goodbye.